大家好，
我是 Stella，
我是蜗蓉。我们今天要演练的是《奇迹正文》第23章《与己为敌》（Chapter 23 ）The War Against Yourself， 以互不相容的信念 ，One 的 Irreconcilable Beliefs。
唯有宁静的心，才可能一起上主。The memory of God comes to the quiet mind. 这记忆不可能出现于冲突的心中，因为与自己为敌的心灵无法忆起永恒的温柔。It cannot come where there is conflict, for a mind at war against itself remembers not eternal gentleness.战争的利器不能用来推展和平，好勇斗狠者的记忆里也没有爱的踪影。The means of war are not the means of peace, and what the warlike would remember is not love. 若非你心中还有战胜别人的渴望与信念，否则战争根本无从滋生。War is impossible unless belief in victory is cherished. 你内在的冲突映射出你仍相信小我有战胜的可能。Conflict within you must imply that you believe the ego has the power to be victorious. 否则还有什么原因能使你与小我认同？ Why else would you identify with it?你一定很清楚，小我诚心与上主交锋。Surely you realize the ego is at war with God. 你也很清楚，小我的敌人并不存在。Certain it is, it has no enemy. 问题是，他坚信这一大敌的存在，而且不打败他，绝不甘休。Yet just as certain is, it's fixed belief it has an enemy that it must.Overcome and will succeed. 你难道体会不出与自己为敌等于向上主宣战吗？ Do you not realize a war against yourself would be a war on God? 你哪里有获胜的可能？ Is victory conceivable? 就算可能，你会想要这种胜利吗？ And if it were, is this a victory that you would want?上主若可能死亡，那也是你的末日。The death of God, if it were possible, would be your death. 这算是胜利吗？ Is this a victory? 小我老想打败别人，因为他自认为有战胜你的可能。The ego always marches to defeat because it thinks that triumphover you is possible. 上主的想法则恰恰相反。And God thinks otherwise. 根本没有战争这回事，那不过是相信小我能够攻击且推翻上主旨意的疯狂一念而已。This is no war, only the mad belief the will of God can be attacked and overthrown. 你可能认同这类信念，但最多只能和他一起疯狂一阵子。You may identify with this belief, but never will it be more than madness. 在疯狂世界里，恐惧好似取代了爱而操控着一切。And fear will reign in madness and will seem to have replaced love there.这是冲突的目的所在。This is the conflict's purpose. 凡是认为天人可能交战的人，所有冲突的手段或道具对他们必也显得真实无比。And to those who think that it is possible, the means seem real. 我敢保证上主与小我，或是你与小我，永远都不会碰头的。Be certain that it is impossible.God and the ego or yourself and it will ever meet. 你们只是表面上相遇了，还在荒谬无比的基础上缔结一个古怪的联盟。You seem to meet and make your strange alliances on grounds that have no meaning. 你们的信念交汇于身体小我，即以身体为家，使你悟性，那是你的家园。 For your beliefs converge upon the body, the ego's chosen home, which you believe is yours. 你们是因错误而相遇的，而这也是错误的自我评估。You meet at a mistake, an error in your self-appraisal. 小我加入你们的幻想后成了你们的共识。The ego joins with an illusion of yourself you share with it. 然而幻想是不可能结合的。And yet illusions cannot join. 它们同等的虚无。They are the same and they are nothing. 他们的结合建立在虚无之上，凡是无意义之物，不论是一个、两个或是一千个，都一样无意义。Their joining lies in nothingness. Two are as meaningless as one or as a thousand. 小我与虚无结合，人是虚无。 The ego joins with nothing being nothing. 他说追求的胜利和自我一样荒诞无稽。 The victory it seeks is meaningless as is itself. 弟兄，你跟自己的交战已近尾声。 Brother, the war against yourself is almost over. 你的旅程抵达平安的终点站了。The journey's end is at the place of peace. 此刻你难道还不想接受平安的恩典吗？ Would you not now accept the peace offered you here? 你先前认为破坏你的平安而与之奋战的那位大敌，如今一摇身一变成了平安的施主。 This enemy you fought as an intruder on your peace is here transformed before your sight into the giver of your peace. 你的大敌其实是上主，但他对冲突胜利攻击之事一无所知。 Your enemy was God himself, to whom all conflict, triumph, and attack of any kind are all unknown. 他对你只有完美无瑕且永恒不渝的爱。 He loves you perfectly, completely, and eternally. 上主之子怎么向他的造物主宣战？这好比大自然向风怒吼，宣称与他断绝关系一样荒谬。 The Son of God at war with his creator is a condition as ridiculous as nature roaring at the wind in anger, proclaiming it is part of itself no more. 大自然岂能与风断绝关系？ Could nature possibly establish this and make it true? 你想要保留自己哪一部分，剔除哪一部分，其实你做得了主的。Nor is it up to you to say what shall be part of you and what is kept apart. 与自己为敌等于在叫上主之子承认他并不是他自己，更不可能是天父的圣子。 The war against yourself was undertaken to teach the Son of God that he is not himself and not his father's son. 为此他必须忘却对天父的记忆。For this, the memory of his father must be forgotten. 被困在身体内的生命确实忘了自己来自何处。只要你认定自己只是一具身体，等于相信自己已失去那个记忆。It is forgotten in the body's life, and if you think you are a body, you will believe you have forgotten it.然而真相是不可能忘记自己的，你也不可能忘记自己的真相。 Yet truth can never be forgotten by itself, and you have not forgotten what you are. 你唯一该忘记的是你那诡异的自我幻想，也就是想打败自己真相的那个愿望， only a strange illusion of yourself, a wish to triumph over what you are, remembers not. 与自己为敌其实只是幻想，与幻想交战，你拼命想把他们两个变得不同，而且认定只有战胜的一方才显得真实一点。 The war against yourself is but the battle of two illusions, struggling to make them different from each other in the belief. The one that conquers will be true. 他们并非与真相起冲突。 There is no conflict between them and the truth. 他们之间也没有什么不同。 Nor are they different from each other.同等的虚幻不实。 Both are not true, 因此他们以什么形式出现并无关紧要。 And so it matters not what form they take. 他们既是神智失常的产物，自身必也同样的神智失常。 What made them is insane, and they remain part of what made them. 疯狂，恐吓不了真相，跟左右不了真相。 Madness holds out no menace to reality and has no influence upon it. 幻象也不可能战胜真相，它无法构成任何的威胁。 Illusions cannot triumph over truth, nor can they threaten it in any way. 幻象所否定的真相绝非幻象的一部分。And the reality that they deny is not a part of them. 你所记得的那一部分才是真实的你。What you remember is a part of you. 因你改变不了上主所创造的你的原貌。For you must be as God created you. 真相从不与幻象交锋，幻象也不可能与真相征战。The truth does not fight against illusions.Nor do illusions fight against the truth. 幻象只能与自己的同类相斗。Illusions battle only with themselves. 已经支离破碎的他们不得不继续分化下去。Begin fragmented, they fragment. 然而真相是无法切割的，它岂会受这小小幻象的影响。 But truth is in...divisible and far beyond their little reach. 你一旦明了自己不可能陷于冲突，便会忆起自己早已知道的一切。 You will remember what you know when you have learned you cannot be in conflict. 即使你的某个幻象会与另一幻象冲突，但幻象与幻象之间的交战不可能产生任何后果的。 One illusion about yourself can battle with another, yet the war of two illusions is a state where nothing happens. 这类战争既无战胜者，更无胜利可言。 There is no victor and there is no victory. 真相丝毫不受这些冲突影响，它始终在上主的平安中散发出清净无染的光芒。 And truth stands radiant apart from conflict, untouched and quiet in the peace of God. 必须先有两股不同的势力才有冲突的可能。 Conflict must be between two forces.力量与虚无之间是不可能起冲突的。 It cannot exist between one power and nothingness. 你所攻击之物没有一个不是你的一部分。 There is nothing you could attack that is not part of you. 你一攻击便为自己打造了两个幻象，从此纠缠不清。And by attacking it, you make two illusions of yourself in conflict with each other. 只要你不以爱心对待上主的任何一个召唤，就表示你已陷入了此境。 And this occurs whenever you look on anything that God created with anything but love. 冲突之所以可怕，正因它是恐惧的元首。Conflict is fearful, for it is the birth of fear. 然而，来自虚无之物，怎么推翻得了真相？Yet, what is born of nothing cannot with reality through battle. 你何苦让自己的世界充斥着自我冲突？ Why would you fill your world with conflict with yourself? 何不让圣灵为你化解这个疯狂之念？心安理得的忆起上主，上主的记忆始终在你宁静的心中光华。四舍 ，Let all this madness be undone for you, and turn in peace to the remembrance of God, still shining in your quiet mind. 尼克看的幻象一被带到真相前，他们之间的冲突便戛然而止。See how the conflict of illusions disappears when it is brought to truth.只有当你把它们当成两个相互矛盾的真相时，冲突才会白热化，胜利的一方变得比较真实，挫败的一方则因着败北而显得更加不真，而沦为幻想。 For it seems real only as long as it is seen as war between conflicting truths. The conqueror to be the truer, the more real, and the vanquisherOf the illusion that was less real, made an illusion by defeat. 由是观之，冲突原是两个幻想之间的竞赛，胜者被加冕为真相，败者则被打入冷宫。Thus, conflict is the choice between illusions, one to be crowned as real, the other vanished and despised.这种心态是不可能忆起上主的。Here will the Father never be remembered. 其实没有一个幻象侵犯得了上主所爱的家园，甚至将他永远放逐于家乡之外。Yet no illusion can invade his home and drive him out of what he loves forever.上主所爱之人必然永享安宁，只因他是上主的家园。 And what he loves must be forever quiet and at peace because it is his home. 你是上主的挚爱，与他一般真实，同样神圣，你是不可能沦为幻想的。 You who are beloved of him are no illusion being as true and holy as himself.你对他以及自己是如此的肯定不疑，那种寂静便是你俩的家园，你们在此活出一个生命，永不分离。 The stillness of your certainty of him and of yourself is home to both of you who dwell as one and not apart. 开启这一神圣的家门吧，让宽恕一烧坠的信念所留下的痕迹，上主与圣子终于有家可归了。 Open the door of his most holy home, and let forgiveness sweep away all trace of the belief in sin that keeps God homeless and his son with him. 从此你不再是上主家中的异乡客， You are not a stranger in the house of God.欢迎你的弟兄一起回家吧，上主早已将他安顿于自己永恒平安宁静的家园了。 Welcome your brother to the home where God has set him in serenity and peace and dwells with him. 凡爱所至之处，幻象无法立足，因爱会保护你远离一切虚幻的。 Illusions have no place where love abides,protecting you from everything that is not true. 如此你才能与造物主一起永享平安，直至无穷之世，凡是有心忆起上主的人，此生不再感到匮乏。 You dwell in peace as limitless as its creator, and everything is given those who would remember him. 神灵回味上主，守护他的家园，却把平安在此，永不受侵扰。Over his home, the Holy Spirit watches, sure that its peace can never be disturbed. 身为上主安息之所的你，怎么可能跟自己作对？ How can the resting place of God turn on itself and seek to overcome the one who dwells there?试想一下，上主的家园若把自己视为分裂的生命，会有什么后果？ And think what happens when the house of God perceives itself divided. 祭坛瞬间消失了踪影，光明暗淡下来，原本供奉神圣性的殿宇成了罪的冤首。The altar disappears, the light grows dim, the temple of the Holy One becomes a house of sin. 你的记忆也仅余下一些幻象 and nothing is remembered except illusions. 这些幻象因着形式上的差异必然冲突迭起。Illusions can conflict because their forms are different. 它们相互交战只为了证明那一种形式的幻象更为真实 and they do battle only to establish which form is true. 幻象与幻象必会同类相聚，真相也是如此。 Illusion meets illusion, truth itself. 幻象一碰头战争，是说不眠。 The meeting of illusions leads to war. 平安所见的景象则与自身无异，他便如此将平安推恩出去。Peace, looking on itself, extends itself. 战争者是酝酿恐惧的温床，恐惧借此扩大自己的势力，企图称霸天下。War is the condition in which fear is born and grows and seeks to dominate. 平安才是爱所愿主流之处，爱也只能在此给出自Peace is the state where love abides and seeks to share itself. 冲突与平安是相对的两极。Conflict and peace are opposite. 彼此势不两立，不共戴天。Where one abides, the other cannot be. Where either goes, the other disappears. 因此，心灵一旦沦为幻象交锋的战场，他对上主的记忆就变得模糊不清。 So is the memory of God obscured in minds that have become illusions battleground. 所幸的是，这记忆的光辉远远超越荒谬的战场之上。只要你与平安同行，便会一起上主。 Yet far beyond this senseless war, it shines ready to be remembered.When you side with peace.
奇迹正文第23章与己为敌 Chapter 23 The war against yourself. 一互不相容的信念 One the irreconcilable beliefs.
愿大家有一个生命充满的一天 Amen 我爱你哦